tiger species, which is another significant thing about Sumatran tigers. Between her paws, she has nice webbing, which makes swimming nice and fun for her. And big tigers and just big cats, a lot of them really enjoy water. And she does really enjoy water.
Do we know how old she is?
Yes. I have a little cheat sheet here because I'm terrible with numbers. She's 5 years old. Aww. Her birthday is in August. She's been with us, I think, only about 2 years. So not too long, but yeah, she... I'm waiting for the day where the chicken goes into the wrong exhibit. So far, I haven't. But yeah, some of you mentioned it. Stamina and teamwork. I mentioned that key family-oriented, very family-oriented, and they hunt in packs. Look at their built, too. You can see they're very skinny built, long legs needed for running for long periods of time. Even to the point where their slim figure, right, that tail helps them, similar to like cheetahs. And then the last thing, their ears. Their ears are for them to hear very well, but their ears are also a way for them to cool down their body. When they are running, right, the wind cools down the blood in their ears, and that can help cool down overall their body temperature as well. Their African pain. So they actually don't bark. The noise or the vocalization that they're making sounds like a squeaky toy. It's very high pitched, and in nature it sounds like a bird. And this is really awesome. It's this adaptation that they have that's actually an advantage, because when you're hunting. Oh.
That's
response
to my question.
Okay. So, another thing, right, that response is because, might have been also because, it definitely does not change, but rhinos actually have really bad eyesight. That's why they charge at a lot of things. There's just a butterfly, you can't tell if it's just a butterfly, so they're just gonna charge at it, and if it doesn't move or it's not that harmful, then okay, they know that it's not that bad. Oh, I don't see where they're going. They're ready to be in the same place. Oh, they're ready to be in the same place. But yeah, so maybe they'll open it up soon. I have no idea, but right now. They're each other. Anybody want to guess what the courtship ritual is for rhinos? So, the females will actually require the male to stand his ground as she charges at him. And if he stands his ground, then he is worthy of her as a partner. They're so
funny. That's an
I don't know. So as far as I know, I don't know if he actually charges to the point where she hits him. I think it's just about kind of stand your ground. What are we seeing? Okay. While this one is down here, he's up here.
Oh yeah, there.
And he's
is.
Looking at us. So, excuse me.
So we're not right.
Okay, good. He will actually, prevent other animals from doing that. You might have noticed, right, his wings are slightly shorter on one end. They sometimes basically do a one-time surgery on animals in captivity. Denial, but now you won't find them near denial anymore. But yeah, they are living in cliffy areas, and they're sitting for a lot of hours during the day. At least 16 hours. And the reason for that is because, right, you're basically living on edge, so you have to be extra careful. But when you're sitting, you want a nice cushion, right? When we're sitting on a plane, we bring a nice cushion for just backing up towards you, or to the point where you can't tell, oh, did you shoot him at me, or did you just throw your whole body at me? But yeah, typically they're actually sweet potatoes. I love apples, seeing them during feeding time, they're very cute. I think right now they're eating lettuce. Yeah, there are those lettuce in there.
Yeah.
In here is actually our squirt, one of our older giraffes. his Hawaiian name is Makana, and then Mr. Z. Mr. Z thinks he's a giraffe. So that's why I have to leave with them. So I'm not surprised that they're in there together. He's like, I want to be out there. Be in here. Mr. Z, you sound like Mrs. Z. I wasn't here when Mrs. Z was here, but I heard that he's happy.
He's just staring at me. Hello.
Pride. Does anybody know what a pride is made out of? Like food and a pride. Male, female. So in a pride, you have all. So they have a limited time where they can have this high speed, but then after that, they're gonna collapse and basically take a whole big break because they just used up all of their energy. Yeah. Usually during the tour, I'll be like, hold your children now, because they have little small children and they see them as prey. Cheetah spots are very random. They're like 2,000, 200, but yeah, they're vertebrates, but just like we are, vertebrates, we have vertebrae is like the neck bone that we have. And that's what they have too. One, I don't have a display. Maybe they'll have some artifacts out later. But basically, if you look at this folder, that's probably the size of one neck bone in their neck. And they have 7 of these. So deep that she almost went into this exhibit once. That's why they actually have like combing the area for predators. If you hide your baby well enough, no one will find it. But I'm gonna go walk around the area to make sure. Is Lily our aardvark live and alive? Let me just say that. As Ray was saying, aardvarks are completely nocturnal. They usually do not come out during the day because that's also sometimes with other children. It can't sleep during the day. I have been waiting to see your face, Lily. Lily is using her snout to sniff the air. Her snout is also very important for her to search for food. So she'll be using, and her favorite food here is actually an avocado. About flamingos is their coloration. They get that from what they're feeding off of. And that's the carotenoid that is in there is giving them that pigmentation. Carotenoid is in their shrimp. But it's also in our carrots. If you eat a lot of carrots, you'll start to turn orange. The orange will start to show probably in your fingernails first, so you won't get an orange.
So that does that too. We'll put mirrors in the back because when flamingos see each other, they're cozy and I'm going to want to sleep because I'm safe. So yeah, a lot of...
This is just a quick pit stop. We have several individuals in here, but we have about 6 boys and 4
Asian elephants, so their home country has the language of Hindi. So when their handlers first brought them here, they taught them simple commands in Hindi and they taught that our keepers. So we got Mari first, and then 10 years later we got Vaigai. And when we got Vaigai, we actually split off Mari and put her to the back area, and then we had Vaigai here, and when they were showing the, or telling her the commands, Mari was actually doing the commands in the back. Which is cool because it shows their really excellent memory. She still remembered that language, the simple commands, even though now she had like adjusted to the English terminology. She still remembered the commands in Hindi and did them in the back. And again, that range too, she could hear it from all the way back there. Elephant, their ears. Main thing you want to definitely look at when you want to see the difference between African and Asian elephants. Asian elephants are like the same. Their ears shaped like the continent of Asia, and then African elephants are shaped like the continent. Their ears are shaped like the continent of Africa. So theirs are typically smaller in size. Elephants in real life, unless we give the zoo some. So we're really, really grateful to them. There's an elephant day that we celebrate.
Wow.
So that's already a long age. And again, he's still breeding. He's still having his mating rituals with his female companion. And,